Hello guys, welcome one more time to this discussion. We want to look at the equation of a circle, and before us we have a question which reads: the equation of a circle is x squared plus y squared plus 6x minus 10y minus 2 is equals to 0. So we are supposed to determine the coordinates of the center and the area of the circle in terms of pi. There are two key points here that we need to pay attention to. One of them is the coordinates. We will have to find the coordinates. After finding the coordinates of the center of a circle, then we go ahead to calculate the area of the circle, and we leave our answer in terms of pi. So let us have a solution. And I want to believe that you already know how to write the equation of a circle. Assume that we have a center. Let us assume that given a center A comma B, this is the center. Then you've been asked to work out or to write the equation of a circle plus a radius. Let us assume that the radius is R. We can easily write the equation of a circle by saying that the equation of a circle is given by x minus a, and we square this, plus y minus b, we square this, is equals to the radius square. This is the equation of a circle. This is how the equation is written. Normally, we say that this one is a standard equation. And what we have up there, what we have is in fact a general equation. What we have is a general equation. So let us start. Let us start with our equation. I was reminding you what I have written here is just a reminder on what is expected of us when asked to write the equation of a circle from the center, and of course given the radius. So we have our equation as x squared plus y squared, and then plus 6x minus 10y minus 2. This one is equals to what? To 0. Now we want to put like terms together by saying x squared plus 6x, then plus y squared minus 10y, this one is equals to 2. We have in fact put the like terms together. Now the next thing is to complete the square. We are going to use we are going to use completing square method to put things in order. Completing the square method. Now we will have to say that this is x squared plus 6x, then we have plus y squared minus 10y. This one is equals to 2. Let us use completing square method and say that x squared plus 6 over 2, this one, when we square this, plus y squared minus 10, minus 10, 10y, or over 2, we square this, then is equivalent to 2 plus what we get out of the square here. we add on this on the right hand side 6 over 2, we square this plus this is 10 over 2, we square again. We'll end up getting x plus 3, this is squared, plus y minus 5, this one is squared, we square this, is equals to 2 plus, this is 3 squared, plus this is 5 squared. So we'll get x plus 3 squared plus y minus 5 squared is equals to 2 plus 9 plus 25. And when you work everything on the right hand side, you will end up getting 36. This is what we get. You get 36 on the right hand side. You get 36 here. And of course here, we have got y minus 5 squared plus x squared, okay? We can now identify the center of the circle by saying we just take these numbers and say the center is in fact negative 3, comma what? Comma 5. The center is negative 3, comma 5. Then the radius is given by, we find the square root of 36. The radius is in fact 6 units. We can go ahead and say area is equals to pi r squared. Area is pi r squared. So area is equals to pi times the radius, which is 6. Now, 6 squared, our final answer is area is equals to, in fact, 36 pi. 36